Coming up on Connections this Sunday, a group of superintendents in eastern Kentucky believe that high-performing schools anchor thriving communities and accelerate a community's economic development. They have some ideas on ways to buoy public education in rural areas that will revitalize struggling economies. And I'm glad to be joined this weekend by Scott Helton, superintendent of Magoffin County Public Schools and chairman of the board of directors of the Kentucky Valley Educational Co-op, and the group's vice chair, David Gibson, who was superintendent of Paintsville Independent Schools. Gentlemen, thank you. We had a really good discussion. We need to have you back to get more in. So you all submitted a paper, and you had some eyes on it before you actually submitted it to lawmakers, but it was some ideas on ways that you could improve public education in the rural areas that could also have this tripling effect or rippling effect for the economy. Mr. Gibson, what was the main thrust of the paper?
The main thrust of it is, as educators in rural eastern Kentucky, our passion is to make sure our kids have the opportunities that everyone else across the nation has. And when we start looking at the funding levels and the equity that our region has compared to the rest of the state, we feel like that we're a little bit behind. And what we're doing is remarkable in that case, because we are distinguished in most of our school systems. We do have the highest graduation rate in the United States for a region. And what we're doing is really overcoming obstacles. Mm-hmm. And what we're trying to do is put out there, listen, imagine what we would do if everything was equal. And so that was the thrust of the paper, and we're just trying to celebrate the good that we do and mm-hmm. say, help us a little bit more, we'll be even better.
And we've had the Kentucky Valley Educational Cooperative on before, Mr. Jeff Hawkins and others who've talked about the great work you're doing with conferences and experiences for kids that really apply real-world applications in the classroom so they can get a job. So there's lots of great things happening, but you need a little bit more, Mr. Helton, to push you over.
Yeah, and you talk about funding, and it's not all about funding, but to me, the one thing that I'm taking from this is that it opens up the dialogue and the communication about what public education is about in a rural community. And with our local officials, if you take anything out of it, to me, it's we're doing great, but with a little bit more and a little bit more shared vision and ideas and funding and all those things rolled into one, where could we be? Mm-hmm. And you talk about some of the great things that KVEC's doing. We just had our fire summit mm-hmm. A couple of weeks ago, and that's where a group of kids that come in. We had over 300, 400, 500, 600 kids there presenting during the day, mm-hmm. and it's a way of them to demonstrate what's going on in their classrooms and present the innovative things that they're doing. So it's a showcase, but it's also a way for us to just to understand what's going on in Davis District, that we can share, and it's crucial that we do those things. But if I could, anything about the paper, it's more dialogue, opening yeah. up channels, and communicating about what's going on great and good and where we're headed.
Yeah, and we'll have a discussion about that as we kind of make our way into a budget session in 2020. These are critical discussions to have now on the front end, and which is very smart on you all's part to be engaging folks in this kind of dialogue. And we hope that you'll engage with us too on Sunday at 1:30 in the afternoon on KET, the main channel, and then you can watch again or for the first time on KET2 at 6 p.m. Eastern Time. And you can watch online after that anytime at KET.org/connections. Hope you'll join us.